Well, our basic resource is the land. And that's true whether we're talking about the South or the Northeast or the West. The land basically permits us to do certain things or it prohibits us from doing certain things. We're looking at issues ranging from the economic impacts of various types of wetland conditions to how valuable these lands may be for not only tree growth, but water and also wildlife. This is the burr of the gopher tortoise. The gopher tortoise is a highland turtle that lives generally on dry, sandy sites. And it was believed that our silvicultural practices were harming this animal. The types of things that we International Paper Company do to prepare land for planting, we decided we needed to find out more about how this animal behaves, what its life cycle is, and so forth. We're now very much aware of the life cycle, very much aware that the turtle is doing very well with our type of management. I think the thing that really makes International Paper unique is our prescription approach. We look at each piece of land and we attempt to manage it in the most cost-effective and yet environmentally safe way.
Our philosophy of multiple use management is one that, you know, the public is a very diverse group and they need a lot of products from the forest. Wood products and paper products are very obvious, but there's other products available such as wildlife, outdoor recreation, non-consumptive uses such as camping, hiking, canoeing, bird watching, various things like that. So we're trying to accommodate and produce products that meet as many of these needs as possible.
We have done a lot of work in the last few years to improve the survival of our plantations. We have new modern nurseries and we've learned how to grow seedlings which are better suited physiologically to be transplanted. We have invested in storage facilities. We have invested in packaging. In general, we have learned how to improve the survival of our seedlings. And whereas we used to have to plant 750 trees to get 500 to grow, we now are able to get 92 to 95% survival.
Our environmental mission has grown in several standpoints in recent years. On one side of the equation, our work towards modifying processes to be more environmentally innocent has been the biggest piece of the growth. The second part of our growth has been the degree of emphasis that's taken place on the mill side of solving environmental problems.
When we were contacted by International Paper Company, they had a severe shortage of landfill capacity and they were looking for ways by implementing recycling they could reduce the amount of material going into the landfill and also meet the overall state mandates to encourage recycling here in the state.
This has literally been a survival issue for this facility. We were faced with shutting the facility down completely because we didn't have a place to throw our garbage away. And when you're in desperate measure, you have to get creative in order to solve the problem. And that's what took place here. We reduced our overall waste generation by approximately 30%. But the total reduction in what we've been landfilling at this facility has been on the order of 98% through recycling and reuse. For example, the flume grid is being used as landscaping material. Knots and screenings are going into wood products. This has been a true example of a case where everyone wins, including the environment. This is a problem that a lot of people around the country are going to be facing, and we feel we have some unique solutions that may be applicable elsewhere.
One of the features of this mill is our overland flow water treatment system. The overland flow encompasses 640 acres of gently sloping grassy terraces. Mill process water is sprayed over these grassy terraces through a series of sprinklers similar to what you'd see in a park sprinkler system. Through the sprinkler systems, the oxygen is added at that time. And when the water and the soil combine, the microbial action of the soil and the plants break down any dissolved organic material that's in the water. This water is collected in drainage canals and then is discharged through gravity to the Red River, which is approximately 5 miles to the east of us.
Let's move it completely back now.
The commitment of the management at the Mansfield Mill to environmental quality is very real, not only for the efficient operation of the mill, but to the responsibility we have to the community and to the state, as well as to the nation.
In research, it's very important to look beyond today. In this laboratory, 3 years ago at least, when the first idea that dioxin could be associated with paper and paperboard products emerged, International Paper committed to establish in this facility a state-of-the-art and probably the most sophisticated laboratory for detecting dioxin at levels that had never before been able to be detected. Understanding the issues that will exist for us in 2 to 5 years enables us to develop the basic sciences, technology today in readiness for that environment of tomorrow.
One of the major areas our customers are coming and working with us now is in the area of packaging source reduction, trying to use International Paper's ideas and our technical expertise to create packaging concepts, packaging ideas that are both functional from a performance standpoint, but also use less material from a source reduction standpoint.
Source reduction can be accomplished any number of ways, primarily by using smarter, more economical design practices, making sure that there is no extra packaging or waste in a particular design concept. It can also consist of using stronger materials so that you can use lighter weight materials to do the same job.
We're just scratching the surface of what we can do with the technology tools and the creativity of the people that we have to successfully create the source reduction opportunities in the future.
We're spending a sizable R&D effort right now to understand the impact of recycled fiber on the full range of products.
It's relatively straightforward to incorporate a secondary fiber into a paper-making process. It's not without challenges, but the major challenge is to ensure that that change of furnish, that change of composition of the paper, does not affect its end use. For example, we have xerographic grades that are commercially available today that contain post-consumer waste.
A number of states have passed legislation requiring post-consumer fiber in their sheets. In response to this, International Paper has come out with 2 grades of copier paper to meet these guidelines. As far as performance of our sheets, and certainly that's a question in a lot of people's minds about recycled paper, our sheets are guaranteed to perform just as any other product we manufacture.
The city of Waterbury has a population of about 110,000 people. We generate about 120,000 tons of garbage every year. Right now we operate a landfill in the northern part of the city, and it is quickly coming to capacity. We decided to compost our leaves in the fall of 1989, and as part of that program, I researched what kind of bags we should use for leaf collection. And we decided to go with the brown paper biodegradable bags, the Garbex bags.
We at International Paper have helped numbers of cities and counties get started in composting sites by offering them our bags and assistance in how to use them and distributing them to the neighborhoods. Waterbury has since used the bags in a working composting site for their leaf collection. Composting is a process where you take in leaf and grass that's exposed to air, light, and water. And over time, a matter of a few months even, the bags are decomposed and turned into a compost or a mulch that can be sold back to the community.
Is everybody loosened up? As you can see, after these trees are about 18, 20 years old.
We've been in a continuous mode of education and working with student groups and other groups to keep them aware of what our practices are and why we do things the way we do them.
Do you feel frustrated on that you're always fighting the company for habitat, or do you feel like you're actually doing something to improve habitat?
It makes us sometimes go back and rethink some of the things we're doing and keep us abreast of what's going on out there.
We've got to be sensitive to public concerns. We've got to demonstrate that we're good land stewards. But I think that we can say with a great deal of pride and confidence that we are good stewards, that trees are a renewable resource on International Paper Company's land. We're looking down the road and not just what we've accomplished this year or last year.